In oceanography, there is one very important topic, biosphere, that is oceanic biosphere or ecosystem, as there is terrestrial ecosystem. In the same way, in ocean, there is ecosystem, wherein it is coral, which makes very important part of oceanic or aquatic biosphere. And corals are very small, micro, zooplanktons found in the oceanic saline water, but these prefer relatively fresh water. That's why today corals distribution, their characteristics and their deposits are of paramount environmental significance in oceanography. And the most important point for the study of coral is that these are at the verge of destruction, means there is coral bleaching phenomena in oceanography, for which our oceanographers, environmentalists are worried, and our world community is thinking to preserve this biosphere and this biosphere. Now let us understand what is coral and what is coral deposit. Coral is a hard, calcareous means calcium rich, rock-like. It is hard, like a rock, substance formed by the continuous skeleton or fused skeleton of members of a group of sedimentary marine animal called cylindrate polyp, means the name of the coral community is cylindrate polyp, which lives in colonies, and when they die, their substance, which is calcium rich and which is hard, calcium rich, rock like, and it is deposited, makes rock or reefs, which is called coral reef, and these live in a uniform condition of ocean, where they develop colonies. In colonies, they develop different types of landform. One important feature of coral is that they have one phytoplankton, the name of which is Zooxanthella algae, and this is associated with the corals physically, on which the coral polyps survive. Thus, this is about the microorganism of corals in ocean. Now, let us learn which are the conditions under which these corals live, means the geographical conditions required for the development of coral or their colonies. Number one is shallow water. Shallow water means these develop their colonies either on continental shelf or slope, and the average depth is 250 to 300 feet, and below 300 feet the salinity increases, the insolation intensity decreases. That's why Zooxanthella algae cannot do photosynthesis and corals cannot survive. Thus, 250 to 300 feet is an ideal condition where corals can survive and coral colonies develop. Thus, these are found on the continental shelf generally or slope. As you have studied that there are different types of muds in oceanic deposit, and those muds are accompanied with coral deposits. In the mud category, we had categorized the corals while studying the type of oceanic deposit. Now the second requirement is warm water. It means corals cannot survive in cold water, and the average temperature corals require is 20 degrees Celsius to 21 degrees Celsius. It means these survive in tropical oceans and especially subtropical conditions, and these are not found to the west of continent where the cold water currents prevail. It means warm water is basic requirement for the growth of the corals. Third geographical condition required for the existence of coral is clear water. Water should not be muddy, it should be clear. It means at the mouth of the rivers where there is muddy terrestrial water by the rivers, or the water is muddy due to wave erosion or notching along the coastline, corals cannot survive, because in muddy water that algae cannot survive, hence corals cannot live there. And the fourth geographical requirement is average salinity. The salinity of marine water should range from 27 per thousand to 40 per thousand. It means the salinity range is sufficient from minimum to maximum. Thus, for corals, this is salinity requirement. Now, there are four geographical conditions. If all are asked in prelims by UPSC and you have to tick any one, then which one you will tick, that is a basic requirement for the corals, because all are important, but the most important will be which. Now you take decision here, because for them depth is also necessary, because in deep water they cannot survive in cold and saline water. This temperature is also required for them. Muddy water is not required, and the range of salinity is a general thing. Then I feel that you will tick this temperature condition, because if you will tick this depth, then in this depth category you will get that along Arctic and Antarctic circle near base or coastline, this depth is found but not corals there. Why? Because their temperature is less. Corals are generally in tropical and subtropical regions. That's why temperature is very important thing. And this no muddy water is available in high latitude zones like Arctic and Antarctic circles. There is fresh water. There are scarce river carrying muddy water to the ocean. That's why this is also not very important factor. And the salinity ranges from 27 to 40 per thousand, which is found generally in the ocean water, because the salinity in ocean water ranges from 30-31 per thousand in Arctic and Antarctic to 36 and 37 per thousand in subtropics. That's why both are within this category. Thus, the best answer will be average temperature, and it will be certified while studying the distribution of the coral on world map. Now, after understanding the geographical conditions, which are four required for corals. Now, after understanding the four geographical conditions required for corals, let us come to study the importance of corals. These are, as we have studied, that corals form the ecosystem in the ocean, or it is very significant aquatic ecosystem that enriches the ocean biosphere. That's why first point is rich ecosystem, and it is called the rainforest of the sea. Rainforest of the sea means, as there are rainforests on the earth which are equatorial, having high temperature, high rainfall amount, for example in a major basin selva, which contains the richest biodiversity and dense ecosystem. Likewise, this coral resembles with the equatorial rainforest on continent, thus they form the rich biosphere where the biodiversity is maximum and biomass is also maximum, because these corals depend on algae. After understanding the four geographical conditions required for the existence of coral, now let us come to the importance of the corals. And they are very significant and important zooplanktons found in the ocean, which form very rich aquatic or marine ecosystem. That's why these rich ecosystems are called rainforest of the sea, as rainforests are very dense, having diverse and dense species of plants and animals. For example, the equatorial evergreen rainforest, where there is high temperature and high rainfall, very diverse species and dense ecosystem and biomass. In the same way, this coral colony can be compared with the rainforest on the land, and these form the rich ecosystem of the earth. This can be compared with the equatorial rainforest in the releasing of oxygen also. For example, the equatorial rainforest in Amazon, called selva, called heart of the world, because this absorbs the largest amount of carbon dioxide, means it is carbon sinking region, and in turn releases oxygen for the animal kingdom. In the same way, where corals are found, there algae is also found, which absorbs atmospheric carbon dioxide, thus carbon sinking. In turn, it releases the oxygen, which is indispensable for biosphere. Second point is the fisheries. There, as we have discussed, that these small or micro organisms are there, and which serve as food for fish, and this enriches the aquatic ecosystem by providing food to the food chain or cycle. Third importance is shoreline protection. When there is coral reef or Great Barrier Reef or any type of reef, Cherbaniani Reef in Lakshadweep, these reefs are wall-like, which obstruct the waves, normally currents, and especially tsunami. Thus, these protect the coastline from the aggressive attack by the wave and protect the coastline from their disaster impact. Third point is raw material for cement industry. When there are coral deposits in the form of barrier reef, Great Barrier Reef et al., ultimately these are being excavated, or these are being dug taken for the cement industry, because coral deposit have rich calcareous calcium deposit, which provide the raw material for cement industry. It shows that till they are alive, they are very important, and even after death, their importance does not decrease, rather increases. Next is ecosystem serves, or its services as a tourism is very important, means tourists are attracted all over world to have a glance of these colored corals. Thus, the concerned government earns money, foreign currency, by these coral and their scenic beauty. Next point is economic value. US dollar 30 to 375 billion, according to United States and United Nations Environment Program, UNEP, the total cost or value of the coral all over world has been estimated to be US dollar 30 to 375 billion. Thus, today we are evaluating these neutral stuff in the form of raw material as the dollar value, rupees value. Thus, in brief, its importances are many. When corals are alive, they are attracting tourists, and they are rich aquatic biosphere, and they serve as a rich ecosystem. But after even death, they are serving the world community by providing raw material to some industries. Thus, the total importance of the coral has been estimated in the dollar. Thus, the preservation of coral is the responsibility of humanity today, because corals are on the verge of extinction due to coral bleaching. So, these are the importance of the corals. After understanding the corals and the factors affecting coral and their importance, now let us study the distribution of corals on the world map in world oceans. Its world distribution is very simple, as you are seeing here. As we have studied, these are the microorganisms in oceans, in especially tropical oceans. Hence, these are found in tropical oceans. Number one means tropical ocean is this between Cancer and Capricorn, not to the north of Cancer, not to the south of Capricorn. These are the tropical oceans. In Atlantic, Indian and Pacific. Second point, on the eastern continental shelf. We have also studied in the geographical factors that these are found in shallow water up to 300 feet depth. That's why at the same time we had discussed that these are largely found on the continental shelf and slope, because these require shallow water and along the eastern coast. Now, let us see their locations or distribution. Here it is Caribbean Sea and near Nicaragua. In this is Gulf of Mexico, this is Caribbean Sea. Why in Gulf of Mexico there is less coral? Why in this Caribbean Sea to the east of Nicaragua there is abundance of coral? This question may be put before you. Here there is a nearly fresh water and shallow water and warm water. That's why here corals are found. Contrary to it, in Gulf of Mexico, due to muddy water caused by the Mississippi and Missouri drainage. Here corals don't survive, rather they flee from this Gulf of Mexico to Caribbean Sea. And now along this line we have to travel east. After this Caribbean Sea, now comes this Red Sea. But here is also sea to the west of Morocco, but corals are not found, which will be explained by the existence and motion of cold Canary current. Thus, on the east coast of the continent, it is Red Sea where corals are found abundantly, especially along the east coast. Here, corals are found. Likewise, on this track, it is Persian Gulf, which is also along the east coast of this Arabian Peninsula. Here, corals are found. And here, also there is one river system, Euphrates and Tigris, which brings the muddy water, but near Sat al-Arab, that muddy water is being deposited and it becomes fresh. Here is shallow water, that's why corals are found. But unfortunately, corals are badly affected by the oil leakage and oil drilling and Gulf War here. Now, the third point on this line, this is first point, second point, third point, and the fourth point on this line will be here, Lakshadweep Island Group, where corals are found in such amount that these islands are purely coral, as well as Maldives to its south is also coral. Why? Because here in tropical ocean, there is no muddy water, it is warm water, it is shallow water. Due to presence of shallow water or Lakshadweep highland, which is marine, that's why corals are found here. Now on this track, after Caribbean Sea, Red Sea, Persian Gulf, Lakshadweep Plateau, comes this Andaman and Nicobar, which is virtually the extension of the Arakan Yuma mountain range southward in Bay of Bengal, and that sedimentary structure belongs to Himalayan rocks, but on that there is deposition of corals as well as their Baran and Narcondam volcanic islands are also located. But here we have to focus on the coral structure in Andaman and Nicobar. The cause of presence of coral here over Andaman and Nicobar islands is the same which is here in Lakshadweep. But question may be that Lakshadweep is purely coral, but this Andaman and Nicobar is not purely coral. Why? You have to explain, and you can explain it comfortably, because this Lakshadweep group of island is located on the marine Lakshadweep plateau. Contrary to it, this Andaman and Nicobar is a part of this sedimentary structure of Arakan Yuma, and volcanic structures are also found there. But the very important thing is that here corals are not in abundance as they are in abundance on the Lakshadweep. Why? Because here, although there is fresh water, shallow water, but at the same time here is this muddy water brought down by Ganga and Brahmaputra system. Now let us move ahead and come to along the same line to South China Sea, where corals are found in abundance, and Fiji Island or group of island also is characterized with coral deposits. In the same way, there is a New Guinea where corals are found. Thus, this is a one line along which corals are found along the Tropic of Cancer nearly. It means it is completely tropical ocean. Here to the south of India, it is located a little bit south, but because of the warm water in North Indian Ocean during summer and winter, as we have studied in North Indian Ocean current, the water is warm throughout year. That's why here, along here in Lakshadweep, Andaman and Nicobar, corals are found in abundance. Now, come to South Hemisphere and start again along the Tropic of Capricorn. To the east coast of Brazil, here corals are found because water is here shallow, and here is a bromely marine plateau. And along this line, if we reach to the east of continent, here near Madagascar, corals are found, and Mauritius and other neighboring islands are also characterized with coral deposit. Move again ahead and come to the east of this Queensland state, or to the east of northeastern Australia. There is coral sea on the basis of large amount of coral deposit, and here is New Caledonia, which consists of coral, and here a Great Barrier Reef made up of coral is the largest coral reef found in the world, which attracts the United Nations Environment Program UNEP's attention. Thus, these are the distribution areas of coral deposit. It means we understood the position of coral, location of coral in tropical oceans, that is between Cancer and Capricorn, along Cancer and Capricorn, on the eastern continental shelf, not west, and in the distribution we have found that these are on the east coast, not on west. East coast, east coast, east coast. Only west coast is here, Lakshadweep, which is an exception and which can be explained separately and which may be asked separately by UPSC. There may be a question that all the corals involved are found to along the east continental shelf and slope of the continents, but why here to the west of the land on the western continental shelf and slope this Lakshadweep coral is found? Then you will have to explain it with the help of warm ocean water current in North Indian Ocean, although the direction of current is reverse but not the corrector. Thus, the next point here to be explained is that, especially influenced by monsoon or pseudo-monsoon climate, it means although the corals are microorganism or biosphere in the ocean, but these are affected by monsoon, because monsoon and ocean system is interrelated and intricate. Thus, we have to explain that it is monsoon climate which is responsible for the coral deposit. You are aware of the monsoon climate which is found here in India. Why? Because this Indian peninsula is surrounded, because this tract of Indian peninsula is surrounded, number one, by water body from three sides and by continental part from three sides. There six sides are not possible, but you have to explain it that from three sides, from ocean, but from three sides on larger scale by land. That's why the complete reversal of monsoon or trade winds is found only here in India, in all over world. But this type of monsoon climate is found also in other parts, because when sun moves from equator to Cancer, the high temperature convectional current low pressure belt also moves north. With the result, ITC jet is also shifted on Tropic of Cancer. Thus, the wind system shifts north. Hence, the trades in North Hemisphere start from southwest to northeast. In the same way, these states affect this region, and this region also. Trades are coming up to equator this way, then trades turn this way. It means this is also affected by monsoon, but here it is not as complete and perfect monsoon as that in India. Rather, this is monsoon-like condition, hence it is called pseudo-monsoon. That's why the very important factor for coral deposit is either monsoon climate or pseudo-monsoon, because you are aware of the fact that monsoon causes rainfall along the east coast, because it is tropical cyclone that governs the rain or the nature of monsoon. That's why here along the east coast of China, east coast of India, and east coast of Persian Gulf, east coast of here Red Sea, and east coast of here this Caribbean Sea or southeast USA receives much rain from monsoon, and that's why water is fresh, water is tropical, and water is shallow because of presence of continental shelf and slope. That's why this is also a very important factor for responsible for the location of corals in the world along the east coast of continent. The same is the case in South Hemisphere also, because when sun from equator will shift over Capricorn, the high temperature convectional current low pressure belt will shift south. With the result, the trades of North Hemisphere will enter the South Hemisphere, and the direction of tropical cyclone will in South Hemisphere be from east to west. Hence, this northeastern coast of Australia or Queensland state will record very heavy rainfall. Likewise, the tropical cyclones of South Hemisphere will cause pseudo-monsoon, monsoonal rain during the southern summers, and in the same belt falls along this east coast of Brazil, there is impact of pseudo-monsoon where there is rainfall. That's why corals are found in brief along the Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn to the east continental shelf and slope in shallow waters due to the original monsoon or pseudo monsoon. So these are the two factors which explain the distribution of corals in the world. But one point is to be explained why corals are not found along the west coast of continent. For this, we have already discussed here that these are not found along the western margin of the continents because the cold water currents are found there. Here, there is one cold water current moving from north to south. You can name it easily. It is California cold current. Here is also cold water current. Its name you can tell, it is cold Peru current. Here there is again cold current, which is Venezuela. Here from north to south, it is Canary Peru current. And here to the west of Australia, it is West Australian cold currents. That's why along the west coast, due to presence of cold water current and cold water therein, corals are not found there. It is an exception that along the west coast of India on Lakshadweep, corals are found because here there is no impact of cold water current because the North Indian Ocean water currents are not connected with any of the cold polar current either from North Hemisphere or from South Hemisphere. And very important point about the distribution is that although these occupy less than 0.1% of the world's ocean area of the world, but these contain more than 25% of marine species and they are living. Thus, these, although occupy less area, but the density of phyto and zooplankton, or say ecosystem, is very dense and rich. That's why these are called rainforest of the oceans. We have studied the corals, their conditions, importance and distribution on world map in oceans. Now after that, the point is after death, corals accumulate, or their calcium is accumulated, which results into a landform, that is a oceanic landform. It is not a landform developed by wave erosion, rather it is marine landform. And the corals live in colonies. Colonies are developed by people, also by Allahabad Development Authority, Delhi Development Authority, Moscow Development Authority. That's why colonies are of different types. Sometimes colonies are linear, sometimes circular, sometimes rectangular. In the same way, corals also develop colonies. If these are linear, then a landform is developed, like barrier reef, the best example of which is Great Barrier Reef. If these are circular, then atolls are formed. These are rectangular, square shape, and in different forms. But for general categorization, the linear and circular forms are prominent. These landforms are coastal reef. For example, in India, on Lakshadweep Island, there are different reefs developed. For example, there is a Bairam Gore Reef, there is a Cher Banyan Reef and Perumal Pal Reef in Lakshadweep Island. These are of small height and small length. Then comes Barrier Reef. Barrier reefs are longer and higher, and these cause barrier to the waves, currents, tsunami, thus protect the coastal, cultural landscape and physical landscape and topography. Hence, these are called barrier reef. Its best and prominent example is in Australia to the east of Queensland. It is Great Barrier Reef along the east coast of Australia, especially Queensland, the extent of which is from nearly 9 degrees south to 22 degrees south latitude, and its depth is 40 fathom from baseline or sea level. But this length, latitudinal extent, is subject to change. Why? Because there is the growth in the number, population of the coral. But the second factor may be that it is also affected by coral bleaching. That's why this data is changeable. Once there was question that this Great Barrier Reef is found in the front of which state? One was Queensland, other was the combined like Queensland, New South Wales. Third was Queensland, New South Wales, Victoria. This way, there may be a location-based question. That's why you should see, verify these locations on your atlas. Whenever you go through any place in newspaper, you at once see its location on the map, world map. Now, the second is atoll. There are a number of theories regarding atoll, but in general, atoll is a formation of the coral deposit in a circular form. These are deposited in a circular form or semicircular form, but these atolls, within these atolls, means coral deposits, there is a water locked in, which is called lagoon. Lagoon is a type of lake wherein marine water is found there. And one important feature of atoll is that it has some open spaces which interlink the water of lagoon and the outlying ocean water. Because when this atoll is under formation, the marine waves are at work, and when the coral will try to be deposited here along these gates, certainly the marine waves will not allow. They will continue the erosion. Thus, these gates are openings are not closed. That's why the salinity and other characteristic of this lagoon lake resemble with the marine water, and that's why the water is saline. There are a number of theories which we will be discussing about the origin, existence of atoll, especially above sea level. Now, after understanding different types of landforms found by the coral deposit, let us come to different theories of the origin of coral reefs or atolls. Virtually these theories don't throw light on the origin and existence of coral polyps. Rather, these throw light on the existence of coral deposits, sometimes above the sea level, sometimes below the sea level. As we have studied that corals are generally found at the depth between 250 to 300 feet from sea level. But if coral is found at the depth of 2000, 3000 feet, then how is it possible? Because coral polyps cannot survive at such depth in such cold water where there is no phytoplankton, no photosynthesis, so it is impossible. Likewise, sometimes coral deposits are found above the sea level, for example, in Lakshadweep. How it is possible for corals to live on the land? Because those are marine microorganisms which live in water. So, these are the different puzzles of the existence of coral deposits which have been explained by the oceanographers and geomorphologists and environmentalists. That's why to explain these, they have taken the help of isostatic imbalance, eustatic change or sea level change, and glacial control. Hence, these theories and concepts have emerged. Number one is subsidence theory by Charles Darwin, propounded in 1837. Charles Darwin was an environmentalist are say botanist and biologist, and he propounded his idea that there is a subsidence of land due to plate tectonic, some ocean bottom reliefs where the corals are developed at the depth of 250 to 300 feet. That land sometimes subsides up to considerable depth. That's why the coral deposits reefs, atolls developed at shallow depth are found at considerable depth due to the tectonic activity means subsidence of that land. The second hypothesis is stationary land theory propounded by Murray in 1880. Murray was also a geologist, geomorphologist and oceanographer who propounded that there is no diastrophic change or change in or the emergence or submergence in the land. Neither land is emerged nor submerged. Land is stationary. Contrary to it, the sea level undergoes change either positive or negative. That is eustatic sea level change. For example, if sea level will be higher, the corals will develop in under that condition, but after development they will remain in water below sea level. But if that sea level will go down, certainly that coral deposit will be seen. It may be exemplified in the Lakshadweep island because it is not possible that coral polyps will go up or ascend on the coral reefs for their death. It means the Lakshadweep group of island might have been under water. If the sea level will go down, the coral deposits developed below the sea level will be exposed. For example, the coral deposits are reefs found in Lakshadweep. Likewise, if coral deposits are found at considerable depth, it means in geological past that coral developed its deposits at 250 to 300 feet depth, but due to global warming, sea level rising, the depth of that coral deposit increased. While it is not possible that coral will reach, survive and develop or give birth to coral deposit or landform at such depth. Thus, global warming and global cooling are the main points here in the stationary land theory. The third theory is glacial control theory by Daly, propounded in 1915. Glacial control means if there is a glaciation phase, means the freezing of water in high latitude and high altitude, then certainly the sea level will go down and the corals will set down and the landforms will be developed in lower oceans. But if there will be deglacial phase, then the sea level will rise and the existence of the coral will come up. In one way, this sea level change, eustatic change and this glacial phase are interlinked. But this may be explained in another way, that during glacial phase, the corals will shrink to tropical region, but during deglacial phase, the coral distribution will be found in subtropics also due to global warming and the availability of warm water. And the fourth hypothesis is land subsidence theory by Davis, propounded in 1914 and 18. This is virtually the modification or modified form in the subsidence theory by Charles Darwin. And one very important thing, that plate tectonic is responsible to explain the existence of these coral deposits, because if we go in detail in the geological history of coral deposits, sometimes these corals are found at considerable depth in the high latitude oceans. Why? It can be explained, and such type of question may be asked. For example, to the east coast of Greenland, how you can explain it? You can explain it with the help of tectonic theory, that in geological past, when Greenland was in tropics or subtropics, along its eastern coast, continental shelf and slope, the coral deposits might have been developed due to plate tectonic activities. Now Greenland has shifted in the low latitude near Arctic, and coral deposits are still found there. It means such type of variation in the distribution of coral in ocean water may be explained with the help of plate tectonic theory. This is about the coral, their geographical required conditions, their importance, their distribution and controlling factors, and at last different landforms developed by the corals, and the theories explaining the existence of such landforms. One important point, coral bleaching is today present or current, but it will be explained in detail in separate video.